So good morning, everyone. I have gone through the interview question and answers which you have prepared, but I think we need to work on it. Okay. The reason being, wherever I see only one or two sentences. But remember, each question that is answered to you, each question that is asked to you, you are at least supposed to speak on it for 2 minutes. Now, two sentences and 2 minutes is not a proper balance. Okay. What I see is you have been just writing two sentences, three sentences. We need a paragraph. We need a paragraph. I hope you are understanding what I'm trying to say. The time. Now, the way we're trying to manage time in our group discussion activity, here also we need to manage the time. So let's do one thing first. We rewrite the answers. You may take help from, you may take help from internet. But the very first thing that we need to do is we need to rewrite the answers. Let's say I have just written my name is and a dash. Will you only write that much in the introduction? Or will you speak only that much in the introduction? Please pretend when we say a mock interview, it means it is synonymous to an interview that you will take or you will appear for. I'm not saying you disclose everything, but there are a few general questions like what are your weaknesses, what are your strengths, what is your name, can you introduce yourself, can you talk about your areas of interest. You know, I want you to answer it in such a way as if you are actually appearing for an interview. That's what we are going to do in the mock interview part. But until and unless we don't have the answers ready, it's actually, these are going to be model answers for us to recollect, to go back to. So what I need you to do is, I need you to write a few sentences, not just one or two. And let's say, I've always been passionate about education and I think you are doing great things. So I want to be a part of it. So what are these great things that they are doing? You know, why do you want this job? There's an answer to it. Okay. Remember, I've told that whenever you are answering in an interview, you need to be more specific. You cannot go beating around the bush. I hope you understand. I hope I'm making sense. Right now, what's happening is it's just a casual answer to what the question is saying. A yes and no can help me. I hope you are understanding what I'm trying to explain. Yeah, so let's do one thing. Let's take a little time. Let's do a little research on, you can take help from resources. I don't mind you taking help from resources, but try and make it work in our situation, right? Because the resource might say that I have done my internship in Yale University. You have not done it. You might have done it somewhere in India, right? Because internship programs are 6-8 months programs. If you have gone to a foreign exchange program, I don't have a problem. Right, but try to turn it into a paragraph. Let me do one thing. I'll write answer number one, introduce yourself. I'll write one sample answer there. And I hope you understand what I'm trying to tell you in by looking at the answer, right? So I'm giving you almost 20 minutes of time right away so that we can rework the questions. Wherever you find a difficulty, madam, I am just able to form 2-3 sentences, not more. Can you help? I'm going to help. I'm not going to write the answers, okay? I'll help you out. So relook the questions as per your groups. Relook at the question, relook at the answers and reform them, right? I'm writing the first one, the introductory part for you so that you have an idea about it. Is it clear now? Is the audio clear? Right. So I'm giving you 20 minutes of time to rework the questions and I'll write one introductory question as well. Okay. So our time starts for reworking the questions right away. It starts now. See, now it seems as if you are working on it and I can see answers being formed, right? Do we need some more time? Okay. 10 more minutes or 15? 15 more minutes, okay? So you just have a look at it. Apart from that, you can also have a look. I've already formed a sheet number 3 where who is going to interview whom has been pasted. You can also have a look at it. Those groups who have already finished with the formation of answers can start reading the answers and start preparing for the interviews. Okay, the mock interviews. You can look into that as well. I'm giving you 15 more minutes to work on it. Okay. In between, if you have any queries, you may always ask. I can see almost everybody has worked on the questions, and it's not an impossible task. Okay, if you pay a little attention, I know you all have that potential to work very good, but little attention is required. Now, what is our next step? Our next step is, if you see sheet number 3, against each panelist, I have written names of people. Okay, so let's say if there are 2 people in a panel, then I'll have got 2 people. If there are 4, there are 4 names. Okay, so it's interviewer and interviewee. You're going to get a chance to look at the process of interview from both the sides. I think there is one name which is missing, enrollment number 31, but I don't know whether the person wants to join group 1 or not. So I have not written right now. You can inform him to have a look and join any one of the panels. So we can have his name on another panel for an interview. Now, what you are supposed to do when you are asking the question in an interview panel, usually what happens, as we have been discussing and we have discussed, that there would be at least 1 person or 3 maximum. So what we have tried to do, because 1-to-1 would become a very hard thing, we made a panel of 3 people, right? Because there are 3 people, I've got against you 3, I've got 3 other people to answer. But the interview will be taken of each individual 1 by 1 by 3 people. Right. Let's say group number 1 has 3 panelists. So panelist number 1 asks a question. Please introduce yourself. So to one person, person number 1. So person number 1 replies. So good morning and introduces. Then panelist number 2 will ask a question. Then panelist number 3 will ask a question to the same individual. Right, and then this process will repeat with person 2, person 3. You can ask maximum 5 questions. Not necessarily the 5 questions that you have prepared. They can be any question out of the entire list that we have prepared. Moreover, not only that, but the candidate may choose to answer the question according to the list, or the candidate may choose to answer on his or her own, right? You may take a little reference from the answers that we have prepared, or you may entirely answer on your own. You make your own answer, we don't mind. Remember, per candidate, you can ask maximum 5 questions. Let's say panelist 1 asks candidate 1, introduce yourself. So now when it is time for candidate 2, then panelist 2 should ask introduction question. What I'm trying to say is the same panelist should not ask the same questions. Try to rotate the questions so that you have an idea of how to ask an answer. Now, sometimes it might happen so that some question comes all of a sudden in between. Let's say, in the introduction, somebody mentioned you like, I like to read a lot, right? My reading is my hobby. And then one of the panelists might ask, right, how do you combine your hobby with your education? You know, how does reading help you in computer engineering? It's a generalized question. You may ask such a question as well. And you can say, see, sir, to be updated with the latest technology and latest information, we not only need hands-on experience, but we also require reading. I have to be updated each and every moment. So reading helps me in a way to be updated with the latest technology in my field. Now from here, maybe somebody, the other panelist may ask, can you talk about a few latest technologies that are related to your field? Now I could not find such questions in our interview panel, so I'm discussing such questions. You may also take a note of it. Now wherever you wish, you can note down that, you know, this could be a question if somebody asks me, talk about the latest technologies in your field, or talk about any one modern invention. When I say a modern invention, it means the latest technology. That's how they use words in the interview, right? So we actually trying to get a real-time experience of how an interview goes, right? So sometimes it might happen, you might not have a question from this panelist. The list of questions that we have prepared for our mock interviews. Do not panic in a situation. Try and think and answer it in a way possible. Let's say if we talk about, I'll talk about my field, the latest things that are happening in my field. So The latest things that are happening is usually literature is all about society and what happens in the society, right? So right now people are writing, people are talking, people are discussing about the situations of pandemic, okay, how the society behaves in a particular time of crisis. One, two, right now even my field of working or my professional field is also interested in translation studies. So what is translation studies? These are actually studies of different works written in different languages and then translated. Let's say you might be very well aware about like movies, Omkara. You might have heard of it. Ajay Devgan and Kareena Kapoor starred and Saif Ali being a very nice villain in it. Right? That's actually inspired from William Shakespeare's Othello. Right. Now we have also examples of Othello or William Shakespeare works been translated into different languages apart from English, Hindi, Gujarati, French, German, etc. Right. So that's translation studies. So right now the focus is that. Similarly, what is the focus in computer engineering right now? So people developing smart computers, people working in artificial intelligence. These are a few things which I know. There might be things which I don't know and you have a very great idea about it because it's your field of work. Okay, so there are a few questions which I feel that there are not there in the list of questions we have, and but somebody might ask, right? As I said in the interview, you have to expect the unexpected. Somebody might ask, okay, your area is in coding. Can you tell me a simple code? And you ask the person to do the code. You may ask the person questions that you answer, because when you ask a technical question, I might not be able to tell whether the answer is correct or not, right? But there are chances of having technical questions as well, right? So ask something which the person can answer orally. Don't ask a derivative or a numerical which somebody has to calculate, right? I hope I'm making myself clear how we will be working on it, okay? Three panelists, so there would be three candidates. Each candidate, maximum of 5 questions. You may finish it within 3 questions. That can be fine. A maximum of 5 questions. Questions can be from the list, can be beyond the list. You may form the same question in various different ways. So instead of asking what are your strengths and weaknesses, I can always ask, have you ever done your SWOT analysis? And if you have done the SWOT analysis, can you tell us about it? SWOT. So it's strengths, weaknesses, opportunities, threats. It's the same question I'm asking in a different way, right? The candidate may select to answer the questions from the list that we have prepared, or the candidate may try and form the answer in his or her own way. That's absolutely fine. It's absolutely fine. But what will happen is when we'll be doing the mock interview, all the three panelists will unmute themselves, and there would be a fourth person, that is the candidate. Interviews will happen one by one, right? A mock interview session we'll have so that we get a real-time feel of how things work in an interview. So you have to take it in a very serious note, the way you have taken your answers right now. Right, so from greeting, please have a seat, or you know, you use all those manners and etiquettes as if, imagine as if you are sitting in a room, you're going to take somebody's interview and somebody is asking for permission. Right? Instead of knocking the door, you can just say, good morning, sir, and then, or good morning, ma'am, and the other person says, oh, very good morning, please be seated, or help yourself with the chair, have a seat. And then the person would say, thank you. And we understand that the person has sat. And then the interview begins. It is not at all necessary to work in the order in which the name of the panelist is written. Name one, name two, name three. So the third person can ask the first question. The first person can ask the last question. That you are supposed to decide as a panelist. That you are supposed to decide as a panelist. Right, we are not asking you. That is why I am telling that the panelist, it is not at all necessary, panelists, to ask questions from the questions that you have prepared or your panel has prepared. You can pick any random question. But one question I think remains common for everyone, that is introduce yourself. The introduction question remains common to everybody. Right? So try to find out a way of answering it. Panelists, you may select any question of your choice. any question of your choice, but I'll not ask you to refer back to the question or the answers. Right? Remember, I'll not ask you to refer. You will not be allowed to refer. It should be spontaneous. Spontaneous means if I ask you, hello, good morning, how are you? I'm fine, thank you. Please be seated. Thank you, sir. So can you please introduce yourself? So you cannot say 1 minute, let me see the answer. You have to start introducing. You know, it should be very spontaneous, on the spot question answers that are happening. So what we can do right now is, you can have a mini meeting, a mini talk with your group of panelists, and you may select 5-6 questions that you wish to ask per candidate, right? What you can do is, you might be using a book, as I have asked you to make a book, call it a rough book or any other book for the subject etc. What you can do is, you don't write the person's name, you write candidate one, we are going to ask this 1, 2, 3, 4 question, and the fifth question is introduce yourself. Candidate two, this questions. Who will ask which question, you decide amongst yourself right away. Because looking at the time, we'll not be starting the interviews today. We'll do the interviews next week. But I want you to decide, because if I allow you to do it at home, you might not be able to complete it. What was happening in the interview as I asked you to do it on your own. Democracy, we need somebody to tell us you are democratic, right? So what I would ask you to do is right away, I'm giving you 10 minutes of time. Right away, you can see which candidate you have or which are the candidates that you will be answering, asking questions to, right? You don't have to tell them the questions, but let's say panel one, you have got Jinal and Ishan, that's the panel one, and they have got the interviewees Ravi and Mohammed Fez. So they will write, Jinal and Ishan together have to write, okay, candidate one is Ravi. These are the 5 questions we will ask to Ravi. Candidate two is Mohammed Faiz. These are the 5 questions we will ask to Mohammed Faiz. And please mention the name that which question, which interviewer will ask. Let's say to Ravi, Jinal is going to ask the introductory question, and to Mohammed Faiz, Ishan is going to ask the introduction question. Now, question number two, again, Jinal will ask to Ravi. Question three, Ishan will ask. Something like that. I want you to have a print, a blueprint of what you will ask when. And what you can do right away is, not everybody writes it, but one person from the panel writes it. Then you can always have a screen. You can always click a picture and share it with your group. Don't share it with the candidate. Okay, I know you are very good friends, but if you are a very good friend to the other person, it's your moral duty to help him out genuinely or help her out genuinely. They're not supposed to share the question with the interviewees. They're supposed to share the question. Oh, Jinal and Ishan are both absent. Great, then you're directly selected. Faiz. You and Ravi, you don't have to appear for the interview, are selected for the job. I never knew they are absent. Okay, those who are present, let's move to people who are there. Let's move on to people who are there, and you can select the questions and try and make out who will ask which question. Yeah, extremely lucky. You know, this generation of people is extremely lucky. You never wanted to socialize with people. Corona is here to help you with it. Right. So right away, what we can do is, why don't we decide the set of questions that we want to ask to a particular person, and which question is asked by the other person. Aditya is also absent. Great. Teamwork. Great team. Right. So how many of whoever or the number of people who are present may right now work on it. Okay, I'm giving you 10 minutes of time to work on the questions which you wish to ask from the ones which we have formed, or there is some out of the blue, as we call it, or the unexpected question if you wish to ask the candidates, that you three in the panel or you four in the panel can decide. Okay. I understand. I could see some of the people were here and have left. Internet has its own pros and cons. So don't worry about it. Whosoever is present or whatever number of people we are present will start working on what I said, right? You have to work on the number of questions that you wish to ask. And if you wish to ask some out of the blue question, as I said, then you know, if the person says, this is my hobby, I want to ask this. If the person does not tell the hobby, I want to ask a question about hobby and then I ask my question, right? Whatever it is, kindly decide upon. I'm giving you 10, 12 minutes of time to work on it because I want this thing to be prepared next time. When we come in our next lab session, we'll be conducting our interviews. We'll be starting from panel number 4, panel 1, panel 6, panel 2, panel 5, and then panel 3 at the last. Am I clear? Don't worry, I'll type that out as well. What I'll do is against the name over here, in sheet number 3, who goes first? So first interview, second interview, that way I'll write it down. Don't worry. Okay. Right now, kindly decide upon the questions. Kindly decide upon the questions that you wish to ask to the candidates. Right. I'm giving you 10 minutes of time to do that.
वीक चल जाएगा नहीं।
I hope you might have come to some conclusion by now. If not, what you may do is you may complete it before the next lab session. I'll mark the order in which we will take the interviews for in the very next lab session. Okay. We'll limit the time to 15 minutes per panel so that everybody gets a chance in the same lab to have their turn of asking the question as well as answering it. Now, we had a question about cover letter. So remember, cover letters, they are written according or like the letters that we write for every occasion. But cover letters are or have a special purpose. Their purpose is they are accompanied by resumes. Now, see, every time when you apply for a job, you might not get it in the campus or you might not directly go to the on-site of or the site of that company. So first, they would ask you to submit your resume. So when you submit a resume in the form of either an electronic form, that is in the email as an attachment, or a printed form via your mail, post, speed post, or courier or something, you'll always have to write a cover letter. Now, what is a cover letter or a covering letter? The elements of the letter remain the same, but the main body differs. Now, how does the main body differ? The main body here in the three paragraphs that you write in the main body of a letter, the first paragraph, you have to write where did you come to know about this job vacancy from. So you can say, sir, dear sir, I came across your advertisement for the job post of a junior engineer in the Times of India dated 30th August 2020, right? And in the second paragraph, you highlight your skills as a proper candidate for that job post, right? So you can say, I have recently completed my bachelor's in computer engineering, and I've also started working with company XYZ, or I have again experience of the internship, and these are the skills I have or I possess according to the needs. And in the third paragraph, you write a little positive note. You end on a positive note. So it would be a great chance for me to work with a company like yours, which is quite innovative and creative in nature, awaiting your positive reply, hoping to hear from you soon. That's how you end a cover letter. Right? The purpose of the cover letter, and remember, whenever we write a cover letter, it will always have the additional element called enclosure, E-N-C-L and a dot. And in the enclosure, you are supposed to write, first enclosure would be your resume. Okay. Cover letters are always accompanied by resumes. In fact, it is vice versa. When you are giving your resume, you have to write a cover letter. I hope this have made things fairly clear. I feel I might have shared an sample. If I have not, I'll check and I'll share a sample as well of a cover letter accompanied by a resume. Fine. I hope that's fine now. And so in the next session, when we meet in the next lecture, what we are supposed to do is we are supposed to take the interviews of the candidates, and we are already been given candidates. One person is missing. I think that's enrollment number 31. Vatsal's name I could not find anywhere. I've not kept it anywhere because democratic country, remember? So we'll see where he can fit in. We'll fit in him at the last moment, and we might make a few changes here and there. And by the time you were working on your questions, and I was also working on them, I've already taken the attendance, seeing the number of people present. So I'll just call out the absent numbers, which I have marked. And if somebody by mistake I have marked absent, you can tell me. I think Aditya was there and then he left. Was it so? The case, I'm not sure. So 29, 31, 34, 35, and 38. These are the people who are absent. Fine. If there is no reaction, it means that. Yeah, so I thought so. So I'll give him a present mark. And people who are absent today, what you can do is, you can inform your classmates who are absent today that this is the work we have done, and this is the work you need to complete. Now you have your mid-semester exam from next week, if I'm not mistaken. You have your next mid-semester from the 5th onwards, right? So we'll have our, the reason I'm asking is, I'm informing you beforehand, we're having our book reviews in the 14th September week, that is from in between 14th September to 19th September, that is the week wherever your lab batch comes, you are going to have your book review. The schedule will be shared by today afternoon to you. Okay, the schedule for book review will be shared by you, shared by me to you by today afternoon in our shared folder, right, after we take our session by 6 p.m. today. So kindly look into it and make sure you complete the uploading of your handwritten book review as well as your PowerPoint for the same. In case you still have any queries, doubts, yes, you have to present a PPT. You have to make a presentation of the book review because it's a handwritten assignment that we are doing. You cannot be reading out the assignment, so you have to present the assignment. Right? So kindly see into things. We are going to do it in the 14th September week. I suppose that should be enough time for everybody who are still pending to do the work to complete the same. Right? So we'll end here on this note. In case you still have doubts, you may always connect to me and ask me, and we can solve out things together. We can sort out things together. Fine. Thank you, class. Have a nice day.